Hello, I'm Dr. Shawn Phelan. I'm here today to talk with you about leg length discrepancies and the clinical effect of them and how to correct them. First of all, a leg length discrepancy is simply an unevenness in the bone length in the lower extremities. Causes of it can be everything from the bones in the femur or the tibia growing unequally, or an arch in one foot or the other collapsing more than the other side, deviation, medial or lateral deviation of the knees, or degenerative changes in either one of those large joints. Even the hips can play a role in leg length inequality. So if you do have a leg length inequality, the first thing to do is diagnose the genesis of it. Now, the clinical presentation for a leg length inequality typically is fairly straightforward. The person will tend to stand with one leg flexed all the time, always the same leg flexed. If you look at them walking, they will walk as if they're stepping into a bit of a hole with each step. When they stand, you may even see one shoulder raised higher than the other, or even a rib hump in the back. Very similar to scoliosis, but this is a structural issue that started with the legs and not with the spine itself. Discrepancies come in various lengths, everything from very large ones of a matter of inches right on down to very small ones of a matter of millimeters. And as far as clinical significance goes, it appears as if leg length discrepancies of 5 millimeters or less, which is about an eighth of an inch or less, do not seem to be clinically significant, at least not in larger framed individuals. Perhaps in smaller framed individuals it is. Leg length inequalities of an eighth of an inch or 5 millimeters and greater, particularly in the 7 to 9 millimeter range, are quite significant as far as the clinical presentation goes. A 7 millimeter is about a quarter of an inch, and 9 millimeters is about 3/8 of an inch. So we do see these very commonly in practice, and these are individuals, again, that have not been diagnosed with leg length inequalities. They are instead individuals that are presenting in my office with either low back, mid back pain, knee pain, hip pain, so a lot of other musculoskeletal pain other than a leg length complaint is what they come in for. But each time we look at a new patient, we start evaluating from the feet up because we are looking at the musculoskeletal system as a whole. And that is often how we wind up finding the discrepancy in the leg length.